this film has been made in Congo.
Right.
That's the first film in Lingala. Not that I had to convince them, but I had to explain to them that this is possible, this is feasible, and we can do it there. When I looked at the script, I was kind of aware that I'm taking the risk that maybe one part of the community will be against me.
For people who don't know, who don't necessarily understand the economic, socioeconomic situation, every stereotype is in this film. And you talk about the image of Africa.
People say, I mean, that person was saying that I'm using stereotypes. But, I mean, we have problems, you know. Our states are corrupt and we have gangsters around us, you know. And also, living in Zaire, or in Zaire, in Mobutu time, it was like the country was run by gangsters.
Being that there was so much violence in it, do you think it's portraying the country in a bad way?
There is violence in Kinshasa, of course. There is violence in Africa. There is violence everywhere. You know, there's violence here in America, here in D.C. So I don't think that the fact that we were watching a movie that has a certain amount of violence in it will be enough to stereotype a whole society based on it.
I think as like African director, we need to regain our own image. Even if we talk about what some people could say stereotype, but it's still based on reality. My job is to say, even if the country is poor today, even if we have problems, we have to face them, you know, and also talk about prostitution, also talk about the relation between men and women, also make a hero, which is maybe different.
In terms of Africa, there is a sense of like maturity where we are. Congo is poor, Congo has problems, you know, and Congo has a lot of gangsters, and corruption is important, and prostitution is also important. You know, and the collapse of the family is even more important. This is where we are.
C'est alors que nous allons profiter de tes marchandises naturelles. Et puis que tu coûtes comme 5, 6, voire 10 dollars le litre.
And so for me, in terms of like building a positive image, is to have the strength to look at it. You know, is to have the strength and the maturity to rebuild ourselves the image and not having someone else to come to talk about stereotypes.
Kinshasa, for instance, is a place where you can find that part that we saw in the movie, but you can also find a lot of sweet people, very nice people. And I've been in Kinshasa for 2 months and I haven't seen a single violent scene, for instance. So, you know, it's just a movie, it's a fictional work. But there's a lot of real elements to it.
We need to talk about it ourselves, because if you do it ourselves, the others won't do it, you know. And eventually, we'll start creating some kind of awareness, because I don't think my film is negative, or people don't have that dignity. I mean, people are happy, you know, I see comments of people that say, like, now I'm more interested in Congo, now I want to know more, all these actors are fantastic. I think my achievement is to kind of create this, like, desire. Because when you have, like, a cultural product, which is, has achieved something, people like it, you know.
I hope also there will be more films, not especially more films like this, but if we have more film, we have diversity, you know, and Africa is so diverse, and actually you can't be one filmmaker representing all the continent.
I've decided to go and establish myself in Kinshasa, which is also accepting that you can fail or you cannot fulfill your dream. It did work well. Now I'm happy, but I hope that we'll start like making more movies to come.